This is an introduction to data management, what it is, and why it is important to manage your research data. Research data management concerns the managing and organization of data during and after the active phase of a project. It is mechanical, managerial, and technical handling of data. It covers, for example, day-to-day processes, storage, sharing, and sustainable preservation of research data. Research data management is part of the research process. If you think of a research life cycle, you start by planning your project, collect or reuse data, process the material, and write a manuscript. Once you are done, you want to publish your work. At the same time, you need to take care of your data. Data management life cycle rotates hand in hand with the research life cycle. Start by planning your data management. This should be done by making a data management plan, a document completing your research plan. You can get help in writing your DMP from your home institution support services. Once your project starts and you have data, you need to take care that it is understandable for you as well as others. Describe your data by creating metadata. In other words, you create information where you describe what the data means and, for example, explain the variables and folder structure and file naming conventions. If available for your field of science, metadata standards should be used. Metadata standards are structured formats that use specific vocabularies or ontologies in describing the data. This ensures that the data is understood the same way regardless who the user is. During your project, either while analyzing or writing, your data needs to be stored in a safe place. It is important to take care of data protection as well as data security issues. When your project is done, data should be published and made available for others. In a similar manner, you publish manuscripts. The principle is that data should be made as open as possible and as closed as necessary. This means, for example, if you have worked with sensitive data and there are no options available for publishing the data, you should still publish the descriptive information that what has been collected and by whom, so interested people can contact you. Data should be published in a data-specific repositories or in data journals. Only if specific repositories do not exist, then general options can be chosen. If your data has long-term value, you should also consider preserving it in specific long-term archives. Contact your home institution support services to learn more about national long-term preservation. You can find more information about data management and related services to the lifecycle steps from CSC data management and storage webpages. If you work with sensitive data, see also a separate section for that. Data management will help you to comply with funders' mandates and necessary data policies and to ensure that necessary resources and equipment are available and where and when they are needed. All in all, good data management will make your project more efficient and facilitate data sharing, as well as ensure sustainability and accessibility to the data in long term, and hence enable reuse in the future. The amount of data is growing in the world all the time, and a lot of money is spent to produce it. However, a big part of the produced data is not reusable, for example, because it is not interoperable, it is in formats that cannot be opened, or it lacks descriptive information for reuse. It might also be not findable, or the data just got forgotten on hard drives during years. In other words, the data has been poorly managed. FAIR principles have been developed to change this. FAIR is a set of guiding principles which aim for making data findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable. They are the cornerstone of good data management practices. The principles hold a lot of technical information and aim for making data and metadata machine readable. Data is made FAIR for people and machines. In fact, there is no FAIR data without machine actionable metadata. In practice and simplified, the principles require the data and the metadata to have a unique, persistent identifier. The data and the metadata should be interoperable and use language which is understandable and controlled for humans as well as for machines. And there should be a clear usage license. Fair is easily misunderstood. Fair data is not equal to open and free. The data owner is in control of the data. For example, open data are often not fair and closed data can be perfectly fair. Fair is not a standard and there is no one-size-fits-all solution. Fair data aims to support existing communities in their attempts to enable scientific data to be published and utilized in a fair manner. It has been summarized that data that are not fair are pretty useless. Thank you for watching.